The engine man had hung there for almost 50 years before being moved to British Steel's Rivet on Works, which is how the engine got its name. There is a piece of armour plate on display in the corner of the room that will give you an idea of what this engine produced. At the Rivet on Works, the engine continued to drive a heavy plate mill and making products like stainless steel reactor shields and steel plates for non steel oil rigs. In 1978, the engine was retired and transferred to the museum. Davy Brothers built four engines to power steel rolling mills. A second engine went to John Brown's Atlas Works, a third to the Japanese government, and the fourth engine went to beer mills in Glasgow. What you're about to see is a short demonstration of the power of this huge engine. The boiler that feeds the Rivet-on engine has been built from steam this morning. Our engineer first checks the pressure gauge to make sure it's at the bar. When it's time, he will open the valve that releases the steam. You might see some steam escaping around the three giant pistons. Once running, the loudest sound you can hear is the huge gear wheel to your right being driven by the crankshaft. As the pistons begin to move up and down, the crankshaft starts to turn. The engine rolls slowly at first, building up speed until it runs briefly at full power. You'll notice that the engine runs both ways, forwards and in reverse. This is because the rolling mill had to move backwards and forwards to roll out the steel plate, a bit like making a pastry. Now prepare to experience the most powerful working steam engine in the world.
Oh, that's quick. Look at the size of this thing. Thank you. Oh, that was good. Oh, I don't know what that noise was down there. I didn't want to move closer because there was people in the left of me, so, and people beside me filming, and I would have got in their way. There we go, you can see the scale of it now.